Good afternoon. I'm Brian Reagan. This is
Tyler Kelly.
And we are coming to you with our midday meditation from Isaiah 22, verses 8 through 14.
He removed the protection of Judah. You looked in
He didn't remember it. He removed.
Yes, he removed.
There we go.
Sorry, I'm just right there. He removed the protection of Judah. You looked in that day to the armor of the house of the forest. You also saw the damage of the city of David, that it was great. And you gathered together the waters of the lower pool. You numbered the houses of Jerusalem and the houses you broke down to fortify the wall. You also made a reservoir between the two walls for the water of the old pool. But you did not look to its maker, nor did you have respect for him who fashioned it long ago. And in that day the Lord God of hosts called for weeping and for mourning, for baldness and for girding with sackcloth, but instead joy and gladness, slaying oxen and killing sheep, eating meat and drinking wine. Let us eat and drink, for tomorrow we die. Then it was revealed in my hearing by the Lord of hosts, surely for this iniquity there will be no atonement for you, even to your death, says the Lord God of hosts.
All right. So he removed your protection. It would have been weird if you'd kept reading and he remembered their protection, and then it got worse. Simple truth is, sometimes our eyes read things wrong. That's why it always does us good to go back and be eyes on the scripture, and also to read it out loud. And sometimes to have a partner. You say, no, I do it sometimes. My I'll skip Tyler. Tyler's seen that happen to me. We read scripture together. He's like, hey, what's your say? I'm like, oh, yeah, I made a mistake. And that's why we go back. Because where we don't want to be is where Jerusalem is. And Jerusalem is under judgment. And they trusted in the military strength that was built by David and maintained by Solomon. That's what that whole thing about you looked in that day to the armor of the house of the fort. That was kind of like the Fort Bragg or the Fort Bliss or Fort Hood of ancient Israel. And they ignored what was going on. And he says to him, you did not look to its maker, nor did you have respect for him who fashioned it long ago. But I want you to see in verse 12 and verse 14, in that day, the Lord God of hosts. Now notice how the word Lord, in many of your Bibles, it's capital L and then lowercase ORD, but then God is in all uppercase capital letters. That means that the two words commonly translated Lord in the Old Testament are right there next to each other. Adonai and Jehovah or Yahweh of hosts. This is God using three designations. A lot of times he's just the Lord, or you will see him as Lord of hosts. But when he says Lord God of hosts, read that as the master, the I am that I am, over the armies of heaven. He's pointing out to them that the fullness of his divine capability to save and deliver them is available to them had they gone with weeping and mourning, had they shaved their heads and put on some sackcloth. But instead, what'd they do? They said, you know what? Tomorrow we're all going to be dead, so let's drink, eat good tonight, and let's party up, dudes. What? Mm-hmm. And so that's why he says, then it was revealed in my hearing by the Lord of hosts, for this iniquity there will be no atonement for you, even to your death, Jerusalem. And who says it? The master, the commander of the universe, the one who has all authority over all creation, the I am that I am of Sabaoth, or of hosts, over the entirety of the host of heaven to work for your benefit. The psalmist says it this way, except the Lord except the Lord build the house, they labor in vain. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman rises in vain. You see, you're going to make this about America, aren't you?
Uh-huh.
We have a hard time even getting people who go to church regularly to fast even for a day. And then we go, how come we can't turn the course of our nation? Everyone says, I just want this COVID to be over and things to get back to normal. Normal was bad. We were a wicked nation. COVID has shown us how wicked we are. With riots in our streets and stuff, we say, how come the cops don't do something? And then other people say we should get rid of the cops. What? You can't have that. But very few preachers and ministers are saying, let's get right with God. Let's speak the word of God. Let's spend time in prayer. And sometimes even those who do, the people who are sitting there, they're going, would you just shut up, preacher, and let us get out of here and go to lunch? We don't want to hear about this having to pray and speak the word of God. You know how I know that? Because I've heard other people say that about their preachers. Now, you know what that tells me, Tyler?
What?
If that's what people say about their preachers, that's probably what some of my people say about me. And you know, that's what the people said to Isaiah and Jeremiah. Quit telling us what we don't want to hear. And you know what Isaiah and Jeremiah's main desire was? They wanted the people to survive. And then you know what comes on the other side of survival when you're with God? Thriving. But they had to get right, and they had to make it through survive and get the deliverance of the Lord to get back to the place where they could thrive and be blessed abundantly as a nation. So as you look at this, and you say, this was about Jerusalem, but the principle is still there. America, the only nation that of its own free will ever said we choose the Lord our God. And now it seems like we've forgotten that. Just something to think about. I'm Brian Reagan. This is
Tyler Keller.
We love you. Have a blessed day. And tonight we'll see you back for Twilight Talks at 8 o'clock.